This Civic Media podcast is sponsored by UW Organ and Tissue Donation. Organ donations are desperately needed, and now is the right time to become an organ donor. Talk to your family. Get the dot. Save lives. Go to heroicdeed.com.
Live from the Civic Media World Headquarters in Madison, Wisconsin, it's the Todd Albaugh Show. And now, pursuing truth wherever it may lead, here's your host, Todd Albaugh.
Across Wisconsin on the Civic Media Radio Network and streaming worldwide in the Civic Media app. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Todd Albaugh, along with Mr. Aaron Zommer as our producer and engineer. It is the 6th of November, 2024, day after the election. Donald J. Trump will be the 47th president of the United States. After last night, well into the wee hours of the morning, exactly like in 2016, it was the results from the state of Wisconsin that gave Donald Trump the required electoral votes he needed in order to become the president-elect. Headlines at this hour, Vice President Kamala Harris has now called President-elect Trump, congratulated him in the call, and she is expected to give a concession speech later this afternoon. We will bring you details when we have more of those, but that is expected a little bit later on this afternoon. Also breaking in the last half an hour or so, the Associated Press has called the race, finally, as it was that close, for United States Senate here in Wisconsin. Tammy Baldwin will get another term. The Democratic incumbent beat her opponent, Eric Covey, by 49.4% to 48.5%. Just that close, folks. I mean, absolutely incredible. Tammy Baldwin has earned another term in the United States Senate. And this from our friend Craig Gilbert, who was on the show last week, former great reporter at the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel, semi-retired. He still writes a column and does some great work still. Craig Gilbert tweeted this morning, and on a historical note, he says, Baldwin's victory in Wisconsin now means that this will be the first time since 1968 that Wisconsin voted for one party for president and a different party for United States Senate on the same ballot. Been a few years. Again, congratulations to United States Senator Tammy Baldwin, Democrat, beats Eric Covey, the Republican, 49.4% by 48.5%. Other headlines at this hour, again, just kind of scanning through, want to bring you things up to speed here. Liz Cheney, of course, who spent a lot of time, former Republican congresswoman from Wyoming, tweeted this morning. I thought it was a salient tweet. She said, quote, "Our nation's democratic system functioned last night, and we have a new president-elect. All Americans are bound, whether we like the outcome or not, to accept the results of our elections. We now have a special responsibility as citizens of the greatest nation on earth to do everything we can to support and defend our Constitution, preserve the rule of law, and ensure that our institutions hold over these coming 4 years. Citizens across the country, our courts, members of the press, and those serving in our federal, state, and local governments must now be the guardrails of democracy," unquote. That from former Congresswoman Liz Cheney this morning. 855-752-4842, 855-752-4842. Going to take a look at how to deal with election anxiety. That's what we're going to be talking about a little bit later. But right now, I want to finish up calls on the phone lines regarding yesterday's elections, how you feel about it, 855-752-4842. This is catharticism, right? Cathartic. Get it out. Get it out of our systems. Be respectful, but get it out of your system. Let's go back to the phone lines. Karina in Milwaukee. Karina, what say you?
Well, hi, Todd. And, I'm sorry. To the fact that you know, the reasonability and reality didn't win this time.
Mm-hmm.
And as you said before, you know, your perspective is your reality.
Mm-hmm.
And we all have to learn. And I think that the main point is in comparison that Democrats trying to bring intelligent and ethical message to their people, yet Republicans go to the point of a fifth grader with a picture book and examples. And who cares that all these pictures and examples are made up, complete lie, straight up lie, and even the lie what they are admitting for, just because it's on the level of a 5 years old child with the bright pictures and very simple to understand that what people can follow. And the reason they can follow that and not capable of deciphering even the simple thing when the Harris campaign was saying on gouging prices. And I had that conversation yesterday before the result with one of the Republicans. And they said, well, what is it all about? I'm like, I'm sorry. She's been talking about for past 100 days that it's nothing to do with the economy at this point. That we have such a high prices in the stores,
right.
It has everything to do with the forming a monopoly behind everybody's back and dictating and gouging the prices.
Right.
We never heard anything like this. If the product is a supply cost more money, then we're getting more prices in the store. No, yeah. This doesn't work that way. So what I'm saying is, and I know I'm a little bit longer, what I'm saying, I think we as a Democratic Party need to look into simplifying the message and repeating the same thing, very simple, with big examples. Here's the person from here. This is what they're saying. And this is what people understand. And another thing is why the Wisconsin are so Republican. Because of the 12 years of gerrymandering,
I want to move on, Karina. Not try to. I want to make sure you got that point out because I think it's a very good one. And I believe it was Dan Schaefer, our political editor and founder of the Recombobulation Area, on Jane Matinair, Matinair on Air this morning. And Dan said, Karina, exactly or not, but similar to what you're saying. I correct me if I'm wrong, Zobbers, but I think he's Dan Schaefer said, if it takes more than three sentences to get your point across, you know, it's too long.
I believe that's what he said, yeah.
And or a version of that. I apologize, Dan, if I don't have it exactly correct. But I think Karina's point is right. You know, it has to be a message that people get right away and can relate to. 855-752-4842. Cam in Appleton, also holding on the line. Cam, we appreciate you holding so long. What say you?
Hey, I think I'm a bit disappointed in the messaging that's going on right now from civic media. I appreciate your show, but why are we treating this like this is some normal thing? We're putting a rapist Nazi into office and allowing RFK to destroy our health system and allowing Elon to axe all these federal departments and people with families and workers. I watched Twitter and it's entirely dismantled. He is not a good person. These people are evil. And you're telling us that we just need to accept it. I'm going to encourage you to skip the anxiety segment because that just feels like further gaslighting.
Well, I guess this election was free and fair to the best of our knowledge. Americans have spoken. 15 million Democrats by the latest results stayed home and didn't vote. So what are we to do, Cam?
Literally anything else, because we can't accept this. When we have our grandkids, if we have our grandkids, I'm not going to have them ask me why I didn't do anything.
Well, I mean, you're not suggesting some sort of violence. That's what the other side does.
No, I'm not suggesting violence at all. But
stop a legitimate election? I mean, it was a legitimate election. It was a free and fair election. 15 million Democrats decided to take a powder and stay home. And I mean, the election is going to be certified. Kamala Harris has graciously called the president-elect. And I'm not saying that this guy is, quote-unquote, normal in Trump. And I started the show by saying we're going to continue to fight and never give up in moving forward with democracy and principle and truth. But to say that we can stop Trump from becoming president after an election, the time to stop him was by getting people to the polls. We did that to the best of our ability. But again,
he shouldn't even be running.
What? Well,
he shouldn't even be running, period. He should be in jail rotting.
Okay, well, that's your viewpoint. That's probably what I would say as well. But it went through the courts. The courts delayed it. You can take that up with Merrick Garland. I mean, that's a legitimate point from Merrick Garland. Why didn't he do more? But again, we as American citizens cannot stop a legitimate election. The results now have been verified, and he is the president-elect.
You guys know what that word means. Legitimate is not – this wasn't legitimate. Nothing about this was legitimate. He should not have been able to run, period.
I'm trying to be compassionate and understanding of your anger and frustration. I feel much of that. But I don't think being obstructionist and saying that we are not going to accept this election, that is not doing anything to advance democracy. We preached that camp at Civic Media and on this program for sure for months, that part of a functioning democracy is accepting the election results when you lose. The person I wanted lost last night. And in order for democracy to function, I have to be willing to accept that election result. Doesn't mean I'm not going to stop fighting for change. Doesn't mean that I'm not going to speak out. But I have to accept the election result. 855-752-4842, 855-752-4842. Let's go to Mary quickly in Richland Center. Mary, thanks for calling in. What say you?
Well, I think that there should be some laws passed in the legislature about these advertisements. When people see an advertisement on TV, they don't run and fact-check it. And some of them were so dirty, filthy, this year that it was just amazing. And there was no transparency and so many non-truths. Mm-hmm. I don't think the TV and radio people should be able to show something like that. And it has to start at the top.
Yeah. I mean... Mary, I appreciate your call, and I don't necessarily disagree with you, but I can only speak for us at Civic Media. We're required by law to carry certain laws. But we had a committee, and we went through and said, you know, is that a factual ad? Can people back that up? Whether we agree with it or not, is it factual? That was our personal. We can't say no to political ads because that falls under freedom of speech. But I agree something needs to be done because, a lot of mistruths and false ads had an effect, in my opinion, in this election. Come back. More of your phone calls on the Civic Media Radio Network.
You're listening to Civic Media. Stay up to date on the latest news and information for your local community and Wisconsin by signing up for our free email newsletter. Visit civicmedia.us/email to get started.
Wherever it may lead, and having fun doing it. Not so much fun today, though. Well, we're trying here and there on the Civic Media Radio Network the day after the election, the 6th of November, 2024. Glad to have you along on the Civic Media, Radio Network as we move on with your phone calls, your texts as well. If you'd like to call in, 855-752-4842, 855-752-4842, your chance to vent a little bit and get it off your chest, as they say. Off of the text line, WMDX Nicole, listening here in Madison, says, I'm sick, quote, I'm sick of people saying this because of the economy. I was let go from my job recently due to downsizing. I'm on food share, Badger Care, and Section 8. I eat one meal a day, so my children have more. I care about the economy, but I also care about my people's rights and common decency, unquote. You're not wrong, Nicole. And I think that's one of the most baffling things for me as just a citizen, a human, right, is to say in 2016 and 2020 even, I look at this result as more confounding in 2024 because people knew all the things about Trump. I don't have to list them for you. You know, by this point, the felony convictions, sexual assault, on and on. You know that. People who went to the polls yesterday knew that as well. And to the majority of Americans that voted, it didn't matter. That's hurtful to me. But to focus on that alone gets pretty depressing. And I think it's more helpful as we move forward. Like I say, let's get it out of our system today and vent and be angry, be sad. But we have to find a path to move forward, right? It's like I said at the top of the show, my grandma was a woman who grew up on a farm. Dad didn't want her to go to middle high school. She ended up being the dean of a college because she didn't give up, didn't take no for an answer. And so we cannot give up. That's the key. And we have to, you know, as I've repeated this, Ted Lasso, the Apple TV series, his quote, be curious, not judgmental. I know it's really hard not to be judgmental as a member of the LGBTQ community to hear hateful things against people like myself and not be judgmental. I'm not saying that we should tolerate bigotry and misogyny. I'm not saying that at all. Let me be clear about that. We need to speak out about that. We need to speak out against that. But I think it's also important to ask ourselves, and just for a moment, to say why. Why are people feeling these things? When she's available, I want to have Kira Sabin back on, our life coach, because she talked about this on the show week before last, I think, with Trigvi Olsen and Reed Galen. Loneliness, right? That loneliness drives so many of our problems, and we don't want to admit that, especially guys, right? Because of, I'm holding my phone up in my hand, our devices, it has made us more isolated and feeling alone. Kira gave us the statistics, Amers, maybe you remember. One in whatever people say they don't have a friend. They don't have a close friend. They feel that alone. And that makes people fearful and angry. And to Luke Mather's point earlier, voters in this state seem to be just voting in anger. And it's not based in reason or fact. It's just emotion. Rather than being angry back, I think we have to be mature enough to just take a time out and say, okay, we have to listen, not agree, but listen to what's driving this. 855-752-4842. Jack in Racine, listening to us on WRJN. Jack, thanks for calling in. What say you?
Hello, thank you. I have just a couple of thoughts to make with you.
Sure.
And one is that I think the rest of the nation is going to find out what people in Wisconsin have felt like for the last 14 years, that we lived without democracy due to a gerrymandering, extreme gerrymandering by Scott Walker and the Republicans. And they lived with that gerrymander, and we lived with that gerrymander as well. So many things affected us during that period that we didn't even know about because they were happening inside government minutia. Example would be not the DNR being infiltrated by the Republican Party, even though Tony Evers was elected governor and stopped investigation of PFAS in the state. So I think the rest of the country is going to learn about that now that we have the three branches in Republican and particularly MAGA Trump control with Project 2025. So my second point is that thought is that I hope that the journalists take an investigative approach and keep before the public and investigate the small things that happen that seem to be small but really affect everybody, because not everybody can keep track of every issue. So the things that are going on in all the different branches of government that really will negatively affect people in the end but are just happening because they control things. So that's been my thoughts today, as thinking about it, say, going forward.
really appreciate your thoughtful approach, Jack. Thanks for calling in and for sharing that. Off the text line, Jim, listening on WGBW in Green Bay, Jim in Appleton says this, quote, "To the elephant in the room, how is it that a major multinational corporation could both win and lose large court cases, one of them costing nearly $800 million, by using the defense of, quote, oh no, we are not a news organization, unquote, and still advertise themselves as a news, fair and balanced? What happened to the false advertising laws?" Unquote. Jim, that's a great question. I would encourage you to listen to Maggie Dawn this afternoon. She is an attorney. She'd give us a better insight into that. Also, our friend Matt Flynn, next time he's on, we can ask him, or Jim Santel on the Saturday program as well. So I'm not an attorney. I can't speak to that. But, you know, like I say, there are certain laws in political ads and television, freedom of speech. And yes, Fox News had to pay almost $800 million in the Dominion case because that was over perpetuating something they knew to be untrue. They perpetuated that the Dominion voting machines had been rigged, which they were not. And we found out under deposition in that case, under oath, that Fox News had to admit they're an entertainment organization. So that's something to keep in mind as well. But Maggie or Jim Santel may have a better answer for you on that as well. Stay tuned. We are going to talk about election anxiety, how to deal with it, and kind of help us all move on. Not being Pollyanna here, folks, but just trying to take a breath, breathe. We move forward. Don't go anywhere. It's the All Ball Show on Civic Media.
You're an organ donor, right? Well, here's a tragic fact. Approximately 20 people die each day waiting for precious donated organs. You could make a life-saving decision simply by getting that important dot on your driver's license. That little dot shows those who need to know that you've made a decision to donate organs at a critical time. Go to heroicdeed.com to learn more about the importance of organ donation and how you can make your wishes known. Talk to your family. Get the dot. Save lives. HeroicDeed.com.
Pursuing truth wherever it may lead and having fun doing it. Welcome back to the Tunnel Ball Show on the Civic Media Radio Network. It is now 34 minutes past the hour of 1 o'clock on this Wednesday, the 6th of November, 2024. Tomorrow's Thursday, as a matter of fact. Zomers, why can't this be Friday? I could use a couple of days.
That would be really nice right now.
Right? Yeah, I know, but it's not. But we press on, as they say. Your phone calls are going to take them in order received, 855-752-4842, 855-752-4842. You can also text us on the old Civic Media app. You can download it on your Apple or Android device. One of those texts from Mike in Green Bay, listening on WGBW in Green Bay, says, "Remember, Trump is the guy who didn't go to the beach at Normandy on this anniversary because it was raining. Also remember, Trump is the one who called fallen Marine sailors and soldiers suckers and losers. Can finally everyone please remember that? Please remember what Trump and his team did at Arlington to the employee who tried to stop them from recording video there. He won't. I don't like it, but we're stuck with it for at least 4 years. Let's work like hell to be better next time," unquote. Also off the text line here, what else we got here? Tom in L.A. says, "Just wait until Trump is in there." Nicole Elon said, "We'll be going through some pain." All right. And here's a listener off of WAUK in Waukesha, apparently a Trump supporter, who says, quote, "We saw through the fake trials of Trump, that is why we voted for him," unquote. And finally, WMDX Tyler in Columbia County says, "Everything hurts. Some things will get worse, but let's focus now on the state. The 14th and 42nd, which cover Columbus and Fall River, where I grew up for the first time since I could vote, and Act 10 occurred. It's once again under dramatic Democratic Assembly and Senators. Don't give up. I'm 31 now. Use the anger and disappointment, and let's get moving on the next state races. We can still make a difference in the state. After all, state rights," unquote. Great point there by Tyler in Columbia County, listening to us on WMDX. I hesitate to even mention this, Amherst, but the race for the Wisconsin Supreme Court will get underway next week, I'm sure, with candidates announcing and that sort of thing. And anyway, let's not talk about that today. Let's go to the phone lines, 855-752-4842. Kathy, listening to us on WMDX in the beautiful municipality of Cambridge. Kathy, thanks for holding. What say you?
Oh, hi. So today's date event. I was crying in the gas station, and a Republican looked at me and said, "Why are you crying?" I go, "Because I'm on the Affordable Care Act, and I'm scared to lose my health care, and I'm close to retirement. I'm afraid they're going to cut Medicare and Social Security like they said they would." She said, "Oh, that's not going to happen." And I said, "Well, I hope you're right for my future, but I don't think you are." So I just hope she thinks of me with my tear-stained cheeks and scared face when this happens. Yeah. And let's move that needle. But the good side is you made my day. Tammy Baldwin won, and yeah, I got my 21-year-old to vote yesterday in DeForest for the first time.
That's
You're
awesome.
Right. We can't give up. Yeah. But we can't give up, but I'm going to feel sorry for myself today. I'm going to allow myself one day.
and you know what, Kathy? Right. You know what, Kathy? Before you go, you should. You should. Don't deny yourself those feelings. It's good for us to cry, to vent, to let that out. It's healthy, right? And hold fast to this. Your kid that you went to vote with, your friends, your family, those are the real tangible things in our lives that do not change because of the election last night, regardless of who we voted for. So hold fast to those things. And if you're a person of faith, hold fast to that. And we move forward together. And don't be overwhelmed by everything all at once. You know, we're going to get through this hour by hour, day by day, week by week, and we'll be here to help you. So I appreciate your listenership and hanging there, okay?
Yeah, thanks for your show. It helps. It does help.
Well, we appreciate
all right,
you.
Bye-bye.
All right, thanks, Kathy. 855-752-4842. Let's go back out quickly to L.A. Tom. L.A., if you can be quick, what else you got for us today?
Well, Todd, I just have a question for you. We have a lot of problems. One, we have Fox News that has basically brainwashed a whole group of people. You have right-wing radio that has basically, you know, it's not like civic media where they actually have conversations. Mm-hmm. It is just right-wing talking points all the time, and it basically is brainwashing their people. On top of all of that, we have money in politics because of a Supreme Court decision called Citizens United. Todd, what do you think? Todd, you and I are both gay men.
Mm-hmm.
We are on the list in terms of who it is that Trump would go after. And yeah, that scares the crap out of me. But I want to ask you, what do you think the solutions are? What do you think the solutions are for the future? If it's all going to be about money and politics and running ads that are about trans and all the stuff that aren't even true, all of this, what is the solution? I'm just so sick of the fact that we work so hard going door to door. We work so hard phone banking. We do all of this stuff. We have record people showing up. And just because Elon Musk can put billions of dollars into an election, they can just brainwash the 50% of the country. Rush Limbaugh is the Antichrist.
Mm-hmm.
Fox News. These people are not in this for we the people.
Right.
They're in this to make their bank accounts larger. They have more power. I just want to know what you think, Todd. Right. I want to know what you're going to do.
I appreciate your passion, Tom, and your listenership as always. And again, the anger, the fear, the sadness, that's real. And we should vent that. We should talk to one another and lean on one another. If I'm being honest with y'all, I don't know exactly what comes next. If I said to everybody, "Don't worry, everybody, everything's going to be just fine," that would be disingenuous. And it would mean that everything that we talked about for the last 6 months about Project 2025 and the like, that was just all a lie. I don't believe it was or is. Unfortunately, I believe some of those things will come to pass. I don't know that all of them will. I hope not. I'm a believer that things can change. I think we have to control what we can control. I go back to what we started with, one of the things we started with, this writing by Venice R. Williams, executive director of Milwaukee's Alice Garden. She happens to be a black woman. And she writes, let me read this again. Quote, some of my ancestors dealt with at least 400 years of this under worse conditions. Continue to do the good work. Continue to build bridges, not walls. And she goes on. I'm not suggesting we should wait 400 years for real change. I'm just saying in the moment, this morning, this afternoon, that hurt is real and we shouldn't deny that. That fear is real. We shouldn't deny that. But as the hours and days move on, we have to put it in perspective and say we make progress little by little. Tom, I think we're about the same age. I didn't necessarily believe that I would see the day when I could legally marry someone of the same sex. And a Supreme Court decision, and thanks to a conservative justice in Kennedy, put it over the edge. And now, marriage equality is the law of the land. I hope that's not challenged. I hope that's not overturned. There has been progress made. In my opinion, we took a step back from that last night. But it doesn't mean we give up. And what am I going to do about it, Tom? I'm going to show up every day. I'm going to be here. We're going to continue to pursue truth. We're going to continue to hold people accountable. And we're going to continue to build a coalition because that's the only way we're going to win elections. I don't know. One of the earlier callers said, we need a candidate like Bill Clinton again. I don't know. Maybe we do. Someone who could just talk plain talk and connect to people. There's some really great people on the Democratic bench. We could sit here and again, we could point fingers. We could say this. We could say that Joe Biden should have stepped down sooner. We could say there should have been a primary, all these things. But at the end of the day, that doesn't change the result. Donald Trump was legitimately elected again as president. That sucks, in my opinion. But it was a legitimate and free election. And if we are to believe in democracy, we have to accept that as hard as it is. But it doesn't mean we give up the fight. It doesn't mean we continue not to build coalitions. It doesn't mean we give up hope. I see it. We just got to do the statewide tour. There are so many great things happening in Wisconsin right now. So many great people, so many great businesses, so many great communities. Those things are all there. And we have to emphasize those as we move forward together. 855-752-4842, 855-752-4842. Charles, listening on WAUK in Milwaukee. Charles, thanks for holding. What say you?
Hey, Todd. Great show. Not the show I was hoping for today.
You and me both.
Couple of things. One of the things about my party that I think sucks is our messaging. Mm-hmm. I don't know how we allowed Donald Trump and the Republican Party to put on this image like he came in to a disastrous economy and built it up in 4 years.
Yeah.
He didn't. And I hate that. I hate that every time a Democratic politician was in front of a camera, they didn't mention that he inherited a great economy. He didn't do anything for the economy except for help dismantle it by not handling his response to COVID-19 the right way. I wish every time they got in front of a microphone, that's what they started off with. Because he was able to carry that. They owe the economy. Mm-hmm. Donald Trump created this great economy, and he didn't.
Right.
And as far as the dark money, I listened before Maggie Dawn and before your show. I'll listen to Tom Hartman. And for like about 2 months ago, Tom Hartman said within the last month or the last few weeks of this election, the dark money groups will pour in billions of dollars for ads.
Mm-hmm.
And that's, I mean, some of the ads I saw were just horrific.
Yeah.
I mean,
they're terrible. They're terrible.
Like Tammy Baldwin was at a clinic with the doctors performing trans surgeries on kids.
Right. And completely untrue.
Mm-hmm. Right. And that's another thing. How is it that they're able to play these ads? And if it's found out to be false, they're not taking down. I'm frustrated. I know that there are a lot of things that the Democratic Party needs to sit back and reconfigure how they're going to, how we're going to move forward. But there are just things that you see in this country, like I said, with the dark money groups that were able to put in all of this money and just bombard the airways with ads that were not true at all. And if I can make one more quick point, Todd.
Quickly, please.
Somebody called into the Earl Ingram Show this morning and made it seem like because the stock market was over 1,000 points, the Dow, that Donald Trump did something great. The stock market has been breaking records for months now.
Right.
And that's the hypocrisy from the right that I don't like.
Yeah, I hear you. I hear you, Charles. Thank you so much for listening to us down there. Beautiful, the beautiful city of Milwaukee, by the way, on our great station, WAUK. Off the text line as well, this is a listener in Waukesha, WAUK, says, quote, thank you for your very, very thoughtful, intelligent show today. Your information and comments are spot on. I'm a mental health therapist, and you are providing a great service. I will not argue with the Trump supporter, but I will make the statement that they chose a convicted sex offender and felon over an intelligent, well-versed woman. That is not innuendo. That is pure fact. I will continue to need more time to process this. Thank you, listener in Waukesha, for your kind words. And you know, look, that's right. We all need time to process this, right? This isn't just going to go away tomorrow. We can't just go have a Sunday at Culver's and feel better and it's all over. It takes time. For many people, this is a grief process, right? Grief takes time. Not unusual. Listener Carrie from Tosa on WMDX says all future roads for democracy are going to run through the courts, and we've sadly already lost that battle. I think the war is over and democracy is lost. Well, Carrie, again, I get it as much as I can. I don't believe that democracy is lost. I really don't. We have to maintain hope. Roger and Stevens Point, listening via WFHR. Todd, by the way, I'm part Bohemian too. I'm saddened that the truth took a backseat to lies. I pride myself on ethics and integrity, and that is something I will never sell out for. And Todd, thank you for never selling out your principles either. Appreciate those kind words from Roger in Stevens Point. Look, I mean, these are just the principles I was raised with, right? Richland Center, who my mom and dad and grandparents taught me, my teachers. Stay true to ourselves. Stay true to ourselves.
You're listening to Civic Media. Find the latest news, information, and archives of all your favorite shows on the Civic Media website, civicmedia.us.
Welcome back to the Todd Ball Show on the Civic Media Radio Network when it's 9 before the hour of 2 o'clock. Coming up at the top of the hour, CBS News, ABC News, depending upon which station you are listening to. And then get ready for the wonderful, the fantastic Maggie Dawn Show every afternoon between the hours of 2 and 4 with our colleague and friend Maggie Dawn, and then Dom Selvia from 4 until 6, and at 6 o'clock in his nightlight with Pete Schwabba. I want to get these phone calls and texts as quickly as we can. I want to read this. This is from a listener on WMDX. This is really important, all right? I want you to listen to this. I'm going to give you some advice. It says, quote, I'm scared for America. I cannot stop crying. I feel lonely. My ex was for Trump. We fought on opposite sides. Today he saw me crying. It's going to be hard for me to really love him now. And today I said if it wasn't for my animals, I don't want to be here. I regret having a daughter who had a daughter. I don't want to see what's going to happen to this world. I really am truly scared. Thank you, first of all, for texting that in. I want you to listen. Pick up your phone and call 988. You can text or you can call 988. That is the mental health hotline. Incidentally, put into legislation that easier number by our very own Wisconsin U.S. Senator Tammy Baldwin, who just got confirmedly reelected today. 988. I've shared this story on this broadcast before. I'm going to share it again. After I left the legislature and politics, I started a coffee business. It didn't go well. I lost my family farm. I lost my life savings. I started to write a suicide note. And through my faith, And through something else someone had said to me, I basically kind of got down on my knees in a shower one day and said, I can't do this. It was old Methodist guilt that what my godsons might think of me, I think, quite frankly. You know who helped save my life? Susan Simon, the great anchor at Channel 3 here, who had gone through cancer, who had lost a partner, who was raising her kid on her own, who had been scammed. And she shared these stories on the air. And I tweeted at her. We really didn't know each other that well. I met socially a couple of times. And I said, thanks for being so transparent with us on the air. And she tweeted this back at me, and it helped save my life. She said, Todd, we can get through anything as long as we know we're not alone. None of us are alone. You are not alone. Call or text her. You're not alone. I know it might feel that way today. I don't want to minimize it because I feel privileged because the pigment of my skin is white. All right? I happen to be a white gay man. I'm in a marginalized community. The results of the election could have consequences in my community and several others. I am trying to be as empathetic and compassionate as I can to this fear and anxiety. But look, guys, we got to remember we're not alone. Pick up the phone, 988, or text. If a lot of people don't like to talk anymore on the phone, that's okay. 988. And remember, you are not alone. Civic Media is going to be here. Our great programs will be here. On this show, we're going to keep telling the truth, pursuing the truth. Our friends, our family, hold fast to those things. They're tangible. We cannot give up hope. I call me naive, call me whatever you want to call me. I still believe in the American dream. I still believe that our best days are ahead. 855-752-4842, one of my great friends, knowing him since I was a kid, Jeff Perry, our ongoing contributor on the line. Jeffrey.
No, he hung up.
Oh, Jeff. All right. Jeff. One of my great friends left me. How about that? Yes. No, I'm just kidding, Jeff. Appreciate it as we're kind of running up against the clock here. Right? Tom McFarland, is he still there?
Yes.
Tom, you got 30 seconds, my friend. What do you say?
One of the things to point out, Trump Day is term limited. We only got to deal with him for 4 years, and I really don't think he's going to make it through those 4 years before natural stuff just kind of takes its hold. And one of the awesome things that I'm noticing about Trump and MAGA in general is it's very much a one-man show. Any of the other GOP members who try to sound like Trump, talk like Trump, act like Trump, they all get shown the door outside of their own little circle. Take a look at Carrie Lake, for example, in Arizona, who is trying to be as much of a Trump as possible, and she just went down in flames. And you see that time and time again. Whenever somebody who is outside of the Republican circle try to expand beyond that, it never works, with the exception of Trump. And once Trump is gone in 4 years, watch what happens as far as a reclaiming of some of the ground that we've lost.
Yeah.
And for us other listeners, remember there's a difference between rhetoric and policy. And if there's one thing that we learned from Trump's first time around in office is the Republicans are lousy at policy. I don't see these guys getting anything passed over these next few years, simply because they're all going to be rushing to overreach the other.
Yeah.
So just hang on. It's going to be rough. But remember, rhetoric is not policy. And it's the policy that we got to keep our eyes on.
Good thought. Really appreciate you. Thank you so much. 855-752-4842. Mary in Tosa texts in and says, Todd, gratitude to you as our rational beacon of light for some of us during this challenging time. Democracy is alive and thriving. May it continue. Mary from Wauwatosa. Let me say that again. Democracy is alive and thriving. May it continue. Mary, you get the last word, because that is what we have to hold on to, folks. Do not give up. We end this show every day with this song. It's not any more appropriate than today. Whatever you're fighting for, whatever you believe in, do not give up. Keep banging your drum. Our friend Maggie Dawn continues next hour. Stay tuned. Banging on your drum.
The national news cycle never stops, but it can be hard to find news about your local community. Civic Media is dedicated to providing quality local and state news coverage across Wisconsin. With the Civic Media app, you can get notifications about local stories that matter to you and your community. Find the free Civic Media app in your phone's app store and choose notifications from the menu to tell us what kind of news you want to hear about.